You know, when I started this 30-30 quest, I really didn't know the following that it had. But you know, the 30-30 is a lot of people's first rifle they ever got. And you know, I haven't done any in the past few months, and in going around to different places, that's the question that everybody came to me and asked. When are you gonna do the next 30-30? So what a better hunt than do two of the biggest game in North America, the grizzly bear and the moose. I'm going to Alaska and I'm gonna get them.
Trophy Quest with John Wilson, presented by Service Central.
Heading to Alaska with my 30-30, and the excitement starts to build. We're here in Anchorage. If you kind of look around and notice, it's almost like airplanes are everybody's vehicles. I mean, all around this lake, it looks, you see, you know, all of the airplanes that are here in the middle of Anchorage, Alaska. Two more plane trips tomorrow, we'll be where we need to be. You know, Alaska is one of my most favorite places, just anywhere that is so wild. You know, anywhere that has dangerous game takes the thrill to another level.
Cleat.
Yeah, what he said. We're flying there from Anchorage. Then we're getting on a bush plane and we're heading into camp. You can't fly in Alaska and hunt in the same day, so tomorrow we'll head after our grizzly bear and our moose with our 30-30. You know, not many people in the world went after a grizzly or a moose with a 30-30, but we are. You brought a backup gun, didn't you?
Yeah.
All right. We're good to go. Just landed here in Unalakleet and landed right here. Went across the Bering Sea to come make the approach and land, and you know, just looking around here in Alaska and here at the Bering Sea, it just, I don't know how to describe it. It shows Mother Nature's power. I mean, just no homes, nothing. You know, this is how it was everywhere hundreds of years ago. It's just why I always like coming here to Alaska.
When we left Atlanta to go to Unalakleet, and actually get to camp, it just seemed like every plane we got on got a little bit smaller till we finally got on the bush plane with Jim Tweedo, and finally got to camp, and it's a beautiful country once we got there.
You know, when I started this 30-30 quest, I really didn't know the following that it had. But you know, the 30-30 is a lot of people's first rifle they ever got. And you know, I haven't done any in the past few months, and in going around to different places, that's the question that everybody came to me and asked. When are you gonna do the next 30-30? So what a better hunt than do two of the biggest game in North America, the grizzly bear and the moose. I'm going to Alaska and I'm gonna get them.
How about this 59.5? And that's with
Fabio. What's his name? Fabio.
Fabio. Fabio's a hair amateur.
See my locks. See my locks.
What's that? You got locks. Lots of what?
Well, you always think of. Everybody always thinks that the grizzly bear is the dangerous one here, but in the rut. In the rut here in Alaska, the moose is probably right there with you.
Moose are really, can really be dangerous. Like I said, I mean, that bull, we probably came pretty close to getting killed the other day. with that wounded bull, and especially in the rut, and him being ornery.
Like I said, it's a big-bodied bull.
God, we're really seeing the moose move around this year.
That far away, it's doable.
We just have to get there then.
You know, Alaska is such big country. You know, we'd see a lot of animals with a spotting scope, but you know, our video cameras just couldn't reach out to really get a good picture of them.
It had been a great hunting day. It was getting dark and it was a long way back to the lodge. So we loaded up the truck and piled in. That's when we heard it. The scariest sound you can hear in the cold, dark woods. Not that. That.
Use your know-how and make sure you arm your truck with the right Napa parts so you make it to the great outdoors and back.
Service Central, service you'll only find at Tire Kingdom, MTB, Merchants Tire, and Big O Tire Stores. Service backed and guaranteed at more than 1,300 locations nationwide. Service Central's ASC certified technicians do the job right the first time. Guaranteed service, guaranteed lowest prices. Service Central, only at Tire Kingdom, MTB, Merchants Tire, and Big O Tire Stores. Service Central, the best of the best.
You know, when I started this 30-30 quest, I really didn't know the following that it had. But you know, the 30-30 is a lot of people's first rifle they ever got. And you know, I haven't done any in the past few months, and going around to different places, that's the question that everybody came to me and asked. When are you gonna do the next 30-30? So what a better hunt than do two of the biggest game in North America, the grizzly bear and the moose. I'm going to Alaska and I'm going to get them.
We spotted a moose from camp on the, basically on the next mountain over. Got on the Orcos, circled all the way around, about a 2 hour Orco ride. When we left camp, he was bedded down, asleep, had one antler. So we're hoping he's still asleep and we can slip up on him, get close enough to shoot him with a 30-30. Down in that clearing down there. So we're perfect wind-wise, and we got a good strong wind. It'll cover any of our noise or anything that we may have. But I think he's down right down over in that clearing. So we'll see what kind of trouble we can get into.
You know, one thing about Alaska, and one thing about the reason you need to stay, you know, more than a week hunting, is the weather changes. I mean, it can be a crystal clear day, and then in 15 minutes, your hunting is over because of the cloud cover and the fog coming in.
Weather's come in. We've gotten in here where we thought the bull was laying, but it took about an hour, hour and a half to get up here and lower foot. And he seemed to have moved. We got weather just setting in on us quick. You can't see over about 100 yards in front of us, but we're going to try to get a little altitude and see if we can't find him.
I'm thinking we should make a run on him.
Still we got, John.
And just so you'll know, shooting my 30-30 and a moose is as big as it is,
yeah,
and we have to get him out of there. When I start shooting, I'm not going to stop shooting until he's...
kill fire.
Yeah.
So, okay. All right, we're good.
So a moose from camp. He's bedded down, got up, and he moved, and he got back down. So we're hoping he's bedded down this mid-afternoon. Is it midday or mid-afternoon?
Yeah. I expect, well, it's 20 to 3, so...
Hopefully he's still sitting
there. Hopefully he's still there. It's the rut, though, so you never can tell, but... Let's mosey on over there. We tried to sweet call him from where we were and it didn't work, so let's go see if we can be aggressive.
Yeah.
Huh? Be aggressive.
He's still bedded down. It's a shame. He's still bedded in the same place that if we were using a long range rifle with a scope.
We need to back out of here this way and then come back around just so we can see him just over the top of that.
A female can ruin anything. When that bull spotted that cow just about 100 yards below, he was gone.
I've seen cows f*** up more hunts than you can shake a stick.
Oh. Oh.
That's the hill that we came off of. It's also our runway where we started this trip. Our camp's right over here. Had this bull moose bedded down in here. We came down. There was a cow there that I think she kind of busted us. I still think the bull's in there somewhere, and we're just kind of holding tight. We're gonna sit here and we're gonna glass for a while. Alders be coming out soon.
Closed captioning of Trophy Quest provided by Coats Aloe.
You know, there's so many moose at Nuna Adventures, it's unbelievable. You know, we get through messing with this one moose that followed the cow, and we're just playing around, we're doing a little bit of calling, not expecting anything, and we look to the right, and here comes another big bull. Just not quite what we were looking for. He was legal, but we were looking for something a little bit bigger.
Just took the death march in this sponge from down there. Got up here on this high point, and we got the Bering Sea. It makes you kind of feel like you're sitting on top of the world right here.
I don't want this to sound like a commercial. I want this to sound like I want everybody a favor. I want everybody to know about this technology of black. We've been up here in Alaska for, gosh, how long?
Five days.
Yeah, 5 days. I've worn the same thing all week, so you know there's no way that I smell right. These are the clothes that my undergarments that I've worn for the past 4 or 5 days, in and out of rain, kept them on, slept in them, and you can come over here and smell them and you don't smell a thing. I mean, it's you know, every time I go on one of these trips, it surprises me. I swear, I've worn this underwear for 5 freaking days. My wife at home is, I don't smell a thing. I swear I don't. It surprises me. My wife at home is saying right now, well, that stuff really does work, because I can't believe he just did that, because I smell them all the time. What it does is we treated all of these clothes in our washing machine. One box treats everything you can put in your washing machine, and it will not allow any biological bacteria to attach to your clothing for the entire season. You know, we were just riding along on the Argo. We had spotted a moose, but this moose, it seemed to be at least 2 miles away. And so we actually didn't approach that moose, because it was just wide open tundra. Well, about 15 minutes later, we're cutting across the tundra, and all of a sudden we look up, and about 300 yards away, here becomes a moose. They're unbelievable just how fast they can travel. And this moose just happened to be coming in our direction. Running along trying to stay with that moose, and it's just walking at a casual pace. And we definitely, even at a run, can't keep up with this moose. We try to run in a different direction and figure out the route of this moose. And usually that never works, but this time it did.
As a Western big game hunter, I've been left behind when it comes to the scent elimination market. Kind of an afterthought. But now with black, I'm able to use my hunting clothing that I already own as another tool for hunting big game. With black, I treat everything just once, the beginning of the season, from my outer layers, base layers, all the way down to my socks. Check out Black by Trophy Quest. I did. You won't regret it.
Hi, I'm IndyCar driver Graham Rahal.
And take it from me, nothing gives you a charge like taking a turn at 200 miles per hour, except maybe a Service Central battery. Every Service Central battery meets or exceeds vehicle requirements with prorated national warranties up to 85 months for power when you need it. Get a charge out of life with Service Central batteries powering today's motorsports. Available exclusively at Tire Kingdom, National Tire and Battery, Merchants Tire and Auto, and Big O Tires.
Trophy Quest, presented by Service Central, the service offering at Tire Kingdom, NTB, Merchants, and Big O Tires. For more information on this program or one of our quality outfitters, contact TQ Adventures at 800-638-1581 or log on to www.tqadventures.com.
Running along trying to stay with that moose, and it's just walking at a casual pace, and we definitely, even at a run, can't keep up with this moose. We try to run in a different direction and figure out the route of this moose, and usually that never works, but this time it did.
It was a good shot, I'll tell you that. There's a dead moose right there.
We brought him in from 400 to 110.
400 to 110. I must sound like a cow, huh?
Well, you look like one too.
You were crawling around.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Awesome.
He's down, down.
Dude. What a beauty, too.
These old buffalo boars, I'm telling you, it hadn't failed me yet.
Sorry. What a hunt.
Wow. Awesome.
Working our way ahead of him.
Yeah, see his tine broke? Wow.
He's a beauty. Look at that.
Look how he's.
Wow.
Look
at that moose's forehead.
Is that where he's been fighting?
Oh, yeah, look at that. It's just torn to pieces. He's got broken tine up here.
Amazing to me, we got up close to this bull, twice. And we try to go and cut him off, you know, almost at a run.
Yeah, dead
and he's just moseying along, stopping and everything.
He's moseying, you can't, you know, people don't realize this, caribou graze at about 7 miles an hour from what I've been told. They're so adept to traveling even out in this tundra, let alone, get in the willows or the forest, and you can see, I mean, I'm wrung out.
Yeah.
You don't break a tine like that, pussyfooting around either, you know. Are you going to leave it like that for character?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's a good character mark. Through the whole thing, it's just a little series of nubs. So you know that that's probably a really old bull. He's probably getting into his elder years, you can see by that side.
Yeah, see how it's
we're coming in at
62,
I'd say 62 inches.
If you're thinking about going on a trophy moose or a grizzly bear hunt, this place is one of the best I've ever seen or even heard of. If you're interested in something like that, call Dewey Halverson with Noon Adventures or call myself at TQ Adventures, and I don't think you'd be disappointed. It's a world-class location and one of the best hunts I've ever been on.
Hey!
Yeah! Go! Oh, yeah! Whoa! Mama Rose!
Grizzly bear now.
It's grizzly time,
yep.
Huh? All right. Give that a shot. Literally.
Stay tuned to next week. We're going to be at Noon Adventures with Dewey going after a grizzly with the 30-30.